For more videos, press the subscribe button and also turn on the bell notifications to receive the updates directly in your device. Hi and welcome to Nehra Classes YouTube channel. My name is Vikas Nehra and this is session number 8 of our ongoing Ansible series. In previous sessions, we have already covered up the basics of Ansible. And in this session, we will learn how can we use variables with conditional operators and loops in Ansible playbooks. So, without wasting time, let's get started. So, this is our Ansible server or the Ansible control node, and we have the Vikas Nehra user account here who is having the passwordless authentication on all the nodes. So, we will switch in the account of Vikas Nehra user and we will first show you the details of the inventory file. So let me open /etc/ansible/hosts file, and here in this file we have different groups. So the first group name which we have defined here is all, and there we have three machines, node 1, node 2 and localhost, while the other group name is db, and where we have node 1 and node 2 only. Now I will first show you how can we use the conditional operators with variables in Ansible playbooks. So I will create a playbook here. So let me write the name of this playbook as services.yml. I will open it in VI editor. I will go in the insert mode and I will start writing the playbook with three dashes, as I told you in the previous sessions also. After that, I will go in the next line and I'll mention the name. So I will write there hyphen space name colon, and I'll define the name like starting and stopping services. Now in the next line we will define the groups. So we will write their hosts colon and we will mention the group name as db. After that we will define the tasks. So we will write their tasks colon, and after that we will go in the next line and here we will define the tasks. So the first task we are going to define to control the service. So I will write there hyphen space service, and after that I'll define the name. So I will write their name of the service as vsftpd. After that I will give one space and I'll write the state. So I want to start the vsftpd service, and in the next line we are going to define the condition, and we are going to use the conditional operator here as when, and after that we will mention the colon, and here we will define the condition. So the condition is it should be present in our Ansible hosts. So I will write there Ansible_host, and the name of the node. So I will mention the name of the node in double quotes after giving 2 is equal to sign here. So I will write the node name as node 5. And you know that there is no node 5 present in the DB group in the inventory file. So it will simply skip this task. This is just to show you the condition and whether the task is running as per the condition or not. Now we will go in the next line and here we will define one more task to control the service, and here I will write hyphen space service colon space, and after that I'll give the name of the service. So let me write the name as crony d, which is the daemon service of NTP, and here I will mention the state. I will mention the state as stopped. I want to stop the service, and in the next line I'll define the condition. So I will write here when colon space Ansible_host equals to, and I want to do it on node 2. So I will write there node 2. So on node 2 it will stop the crony d service. Now I'll go in the next line and I'll close this Ansible playbook file. So I will write there three dots and I'll save it. Now I'm going to show you the execution of this playbook. So to run this playbook I will write ansible hyphen playbook services.yml. as soon as I will press enter here, it will start running the Ansible playbook. So you can see that the playbook is running, it is gathering the facts, and here it is showing us the status as OK on both the nodes, And in the first task field, you can see that it is showing us the status as skipping on both the nodes. Since the first task we defined only for the node 5, so it will automatically skip the task on the node 1 and node 2, and there is no node 5 present in our group. So our conditional operator is working perfectly. In the next task, you can see that it is skipping the task on node 1, since there we have defined node 2 only, and on node 2 it is showing us the status as okay. And here in the output also you can see these details. So the conditional operator that we have used in this playbook is working perfectly fine. Now I will show you how can we use the loops in Ansible playbook files. To show you the working of loops in Ansible playbooks, I'm going to create one more playbook file here with the name as loops.yml, and I'm going to use the VI editor for that. So I'll go in the insert mode and start writing the playbook with three dashes. After that, I'll go in the next line, and there I'll mention hyphen space name, and I'll give the name to this. So I can write the name as installing multiple packages. After that, I will go in the next line and I will write their hosts colon, and I can define the group name like all, since I want to install the packages on all the nodes. After that, we will mention the tasks. So I will write their tasks colon, and after that, to define the tasks, we will go in the next line, and we have to make sure that we start writing just below the S. So I will mention here hyphen space, and I will define the name to this task, and I will mention the name to this task as install packages. And after that, we will go in the next line where we will define the yum module, which will allow us to install the packages. So I will write there yum colon and the name, and in the name field we can define the packages. But the problem here is that we want to install the multiple packages, so we have to define them using the variable. So we can mention here item in the double quotes, and this item is there for the package's name. And after that, we will give one space and we will mention the state as latest, since we want to install the latest packages. But this method is not allowed, or it will not be allowed after Ansible 2.11. We cannot define the loops like this. We cannot use the lists there. So if we will do it like this on Ansible 2.9, which is the current version, it will just show us an error. But after 2.11, it will not allow us to use this method. There we have to define the items in the square brackets. That I will show you as well later. Now in the next line, we have to call the package's name. So for that, we can mention with items colon, and to define the package's names, we will go in the next line and we will start writing from the same distance, and there we will define the package's names with hyphen and space. So here I will mention the first package name as httpd. After that, I will mention the second package name as vsftpd hyphen ftp. Make sure that you give a space between hyphen and the package name, and each package name must be defined in the separate line. And one more package name like zsh. So I want to install these four packages on all the nodes. After that, I will close the playbook file. So I will go in the next line and I'll put three dots and I will save it. Now we are going to execute this playbook from the normal user account, and installing the packages on a machine requires the root privilege, so it will throw an error and it will show us the warning for the method that we have used to define the loops. So we will get one warning and one error if we will run it from the normal user account. So let me execute this playbook. So I will write here ansible hyphen playbook loops.yml, press enter here. So here you can see that it is gathering the facts. It is showing us the status as okay on all the nodes, but in the task field it is showing us the warning, and here it is saying us that you cannot specify the names like this. You should use square brackets, and there within single quotes you should define the names. And this feature will be removed in version 2.11. Although we are not using 2.11, so it will work for us, but it will keep showing us the error. And this warning we can disable by making the changes in the ansible.cfg file in the etc directory. You can make it depreciation_warnings is equal to false if you want to disable this warning. But ideally we should use this method, which is the new, and I'll show you that method as well. Now coming to the status of the playbook, here it is showing us the status as failed because it requires the root user privilege to install the packages. So we have to do it either from the root user account or by using the sudo credentials or the sudo privilege. And this Vikas Nara user is already added in the sudoers file in all the machines. So in order to use the sudo access, we can mention hyphen become here. So this time it will use the admin access using the sudoers file, and it will install the packages. And here you can see the status. It is showing us the status has changed and it has successfully installed all the packages on all the machines. You can have a look at this. Now I'm going to show you how can you use the new method to define the loops. Now I'm going to show you the method that we should use to use the loops on Ansible 2.11 and above. So for that, let me create one more file here with the name as loopsnew.yml, and I'm using vi editor here. So I will go in the insert mode, I will put three dashes, and in the next line I will mention dash hyphen name, and I'll give the name as installing packages in Ansible 2.11. after that we will go in the next line, and here we will define the hosts. I will write the group name as all. After that I'll go in the next line and I'll define the tasks. So I will write their tasks colon, and then in the next line we will start writing from just below the S, and here we will mention the name of the task. So I'll mention the name as installing packages. After that we will go in the next line and we will call the yum module. So we will write their yum colon, and after that we will go in the next line, and here we will mention the name, and here we can define the packages names. So we will go in the next line simply and we will start writing just below the name, and here we can define the packages names, like I want to install Nginx, so I can write there Nginx. After that the next package name, like I want to install PostgreSQL, and after that we can define the state as well, of course. So we will go in the next line, and here we can define the state. So state must be present to install the packages. After that we will go in the next line and we will put three dots to close it, and we can save this file. And instead of defining them like this, we could have used these square brackets as well, that I'll show you also. Now I will save this file and I will run it. So I will mention Ansible hyphen playbook loopsnew.yml, and of course hyphen become, to use the sudo access. So this command will run the playbook and it will install the packages which we have mentioned in the playbook file. And here it is, you can see that it has changed the status as per the tasks and it has installed the packages there. Now I'm going to show you how can we use the square brackets to define the lists. So again open the file in VI editor, and here remove the lists. So you don't need to mention hyphen and the package name, you can just define it in the name field in the square bracket like this. So you have to mention square bracket, and in the single quotes you can mention the package name, like I want to install GCC. For the next package I will first put one comma and give one space, and the next package name I can define in the single quotes, like I will define the package name as make, again I will put comma, and I can define the next package name like EPEL hyphen release, and you can mention the more names as well if you want. After that you can save it and you can run the playbook. So Ansible hyphen playbook the playbook name and hyphen become. So this will execute the playbook file and this will perform the tasks as we have mentioned in the playbook. And this method will work on all the Ansible versions. So you don't need to worry about the version if you are using this method to use the loops in Ansible. So guys, that's it from my side for today's session. Hope you will find this session useful for you. If you like it, then do share it with your friends and colleagues and give a like to this video. And if you are new on this channel, then please subscribe us and turn on the bell notification. I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye. Jai Hind. Vande Mataram.